I was 4 years old when we were attacked on Yom Kippur. I remember us running to the shelter in Tel Aviv. It's very concrete for a child. They want to kill us. And I really didn't understand, why do they hate us so much?
ناصر اخوي كان اصغر مني له كان تقريبا عمره 14 سنه الجيش اللي حكوا له اطلقوا عليه رصاصه انا ما بعرفش كيف هذيك اللحظه قدرت اتحمل الموقف
كان عندي حلم اني اكون مقاتل في صفوف الثوره الفلسطينيه يعني واكون جزء من الكفاح المسلح ضد الاحتلال كنت مستعد انه اموت في سبيل هاي الافكار
I was admitted into the most prestigious unit in the Israeli army. I was extremely proud. I knew my father was proud.
صرت أفكر كتير. إيش أنا دوري في الحياة هنا؟ فاخترت إني أعمل عملية استشهادية. زي ما كومم، بس ما نجيش تغور. كاخا ما نجيش تغور بيني.
מישהו התקשר ואמר שיש פלסטינים שמוכנים להיפגש איתנו.
كنت كثير خايف انه قد يكون في مصيده يعني هون.
We find that we actually have something in common. That willingness to kill people you don't know.
عندهم قوة جميلة مش طبيعي. بده يجي كم واحد من المقاتلين لأجل السلام رفضوا الخدمة يغيروها.
إذا أنت كريتي عن نيلسون مانديلا شخص لحاله غير دوله كان كل الدنيا وغير كل النظام وانت بتعرف انه شخص لحاله كل شخص لحاله كيف قدر يسوي هيك كيف قدر يسوي
אנחנו מזמינים את כוחות הביטחון לפשוט את המדים ולהצטרף אלינו
انا بفقدش الامل في فكره ان السلام انه ما في طريق ثاني غير السلام
How did you find this group of like the ex the army guys from the Israeli army and that was that an already existing group how did you find out about them to reach out to them
firstly I knew about this group from the media because I
television media
I read Hebrew and Arabic, so I follow the Israeli media as well, our media, the Arabic media. And second, this was also another process of building trust among each other. Ultimately, this in our year time, we name it Combatants for Peace after a lot of discussions. You know, when you put Israelis and Palestinians in the room, there are a million opinions, so it was not easy also to agree on the name and the slogan and all the principles, but mainly it was main big principle that both sides reach the point after fighting, after being in the army or being in jail, there is no military solution for our conflict. We both are there to stay there, and we have to find a way to manage with each other. And this way is the only way, which is a joint non-violence culture and path and struggle. And that's what we do, and that's what We inspired by even what happened in the US back in the days with Martin Luther King freedom marches, and that's what we do now every month, actually.
And the real solution is the human solution.
Yeah, it's, you know, in a conflict zone, like not just in Palestine, Israel, everywhere.
Yes.
That people don't see each other as a human, first of all. And that's the way how they could dehumanizing each other and hate and kill and all that. And it was, I would say from my experience, It's very important to reconnect to our humanity and you know what this revolutionary person in South America said, stay human.